Guys, welcome back to another edition of Toy Room Insanity. This is episode 103. On May 25th, 1983, Star Wars Return of the Jedi hit the movie theaters. Towards the beginning of the movie, we catch up with our heroes C-3PO, R2-D2, Luke Skywalker, Princess Leia, Chewbacca, and Lando Calrissian. They're on a rescue mission to get Han Solo back from Jabba the Hutt. In The Empire Strikes Back, Han Solo was frozen in carbonite and is now being displayed as a trophy inside of Jabba's palace. First up in the rescue plan, C-3PO becomes Jabba the Hutt's translator, and R2-D2 becomes a cocktail waiter. Next, Princess Leia removes Han Solo from his carbonite freeze, and then Han and Chewie become imprisoned together in one of Jabba's cell, and then Princess Leia becomes Jabba's slave. Luke Skywalker finally shows up and is captured after trying to defeat Jabba's Rancor. And all this time, Lando Calrissian is disguised in one of Jabba's guards and goes totally undetected. And now Jabba loads his crew and our heroes on what is known to many as Jabba's cell barge, but it's actually called the Katana, and they cruise over the dunes of Tatooine. Jabba the Hutt is taking Han Solo, Chewbacca, and Luke Skywalker out to the Dune Sea to be tossed into the great pit of Carkoon to be digested by the Sarlacc. Shortly after the arrival of the Sarlacc, R2-D2 launches Luke Skywalker's saber over to him. He catches it, they fight their way free, Boba Fett falls into the Sarlacc, and the Katana is destroyed. As many of you know, Kenner made all the original Star Wars toys. During this time, they made a few large-sized toys like the Millennium Falcon, the Imperial Shuttle, and the Death Star. The Katana would never see the light of day by Kenner. However, Kenner did make toys for Return of the Jedi that came straight from Jabba's palace, such as Jabba the Hutt, the Gamorrean Guard, Bib Fortuna, Rancor Keeper, Klaatu, Klaatu Skiff Guard, Weequay, Nikto, Skiff Guard Lando Calrissian, Ree Yeese, Squidhead, 8D8, Barada, EV99, Han Solo and Carbonite, R2-D2 with pop-up lightsaber, Yak Face, who was only available in Canada in European stores, Slice Noodles and the Rebo Band, the Rancor Monster, the Jabba the Hutt Dungeon Sears exclusive playset. Kenner did make two vehicles that came straight out of Jabba the Hutt's palace. First up, we got the Tatooine Skiff that you saw right alongside the Katani in the movie. They also made the Desert Sail Skiff, which was not in the movie, but was part of the mini rigs. Now fast forward to February of 2018 at Toy Fair, where Hasbro announces a brand new crowdfunding platform called HasLab, where they show off a brand new 4-foot-long prototype of a Katana that's supposed to go alongside of their Star Wars Vintage Collection toy line. In order to make this brand new HasLab Katana reality, they needed 5,000 Katanas purchased. They need 5,000 backers, basically. So they gave us from February 28th of 2018 to April 3rd at 11:59 p.m. Eastern Time, just before midnight, to buy the back the barge. During the first month, the backers of the barge came slowly, probably because it cost $500. So HasLab sweetened the deal, and they added an exclusive vintage collection, Power of the Force Yak Face, at no extra charge. And once everybody found out about the Yak Face, all the backers came and they hit the 5,000 backers, but at the very end, it actually sold 8,810 barges. On April 25th, 2018, HasLab sent out this book called Jabba's Cell Barge, a Katana, behind the workbench to all their backers. Just a bit over a year later, here in the early weeks of March of 2019, the barge has shipped and been received by many collectors. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Star Wars Vintage Collection, Jabba's Cell Barge, the Katana. All right, this is the shipping box for the Katana. As you can see, it barely fits into the shot. Here is our tape measure. And it measures a total of just a tad over 4 feet, 5 inches. And now, the first incision. Another box inside. Yeah, the Katana comes with a secondary box to make sure that your Katana doesn't get destroyed by USPS or FedEx. It's FedEx, right? Who shipped this, so yeah. So even though that there are boxes out there that were pretty well damaged. Not too much. I don't want Jack in the Box. Ooh, honey, get it tonight. Get some of that katana juice on your head. Look at all this. Packaging here must be nutty. Look at that. Look. Wow, let's get this thing out of here. Wow. Amazing.
All right, so here's a sail barge out of its shipping container, its shipping box, in its basic vintage collection style packaging. And it is massively huge, and it takes up a huge amount of space here in the toy room of insanity. We have a really awesome photo of the barge here in the front. As you can see, this is a Jabba sail barge, the Katana. And it goes all the way down. This is a massive, huge box. And of course, yes, it does include the Yak Face action figure. And across the top, we have some shots of the Katana with some figures on the inside of it, just giving you some ideas of what you could do on setting up some dioramas or buying more figures, right? Because Hasbro wants you to buy their Star Wars figures. And you gotta fill some of the figures, you have to. So just don't buy the Katana, you gotta load them up with your army of figures for Jabba's Palace. Both sides of the box have the same imprint, just like this. And just like so many classic vintage packaging of Star Wars toys back in the good old days of Kenner, they have the alternate black and white shot of the Katana here on the back of the packaging. It looks so awesome. All right, here's Matt Strange. He's gonna show us how to open up the box for the Katana.
All right, so what you gotta do here first is just lift up the three flaps in the back. Once you do that, you're gonna see these little teeth. This is going to allow you to pull the backing out right here. Same with the sides. Once you do that here, you kind of get these little lips out. And then this top is going to fold out. Hasbro has allowed us to dismantle the box without any damage. So just take care when you are doing this, if you're removing the flaps appropriately. That way you can display the box later on or just keep it nice. Same thing over here. You want to make sure you're going like this. Some of them are a little difficult. Let's get this guy here. All right. And the whole thing so just falls apart.
Here. We unfoldeth. We unfoldeth the box.
Stop.
Read before. I wish I could give you guys a wider stance, but it's just impossible. But there is a Katana in its foam packaging, styrofoam packaging, and there's a box. So you could basically unfold this whole box and hang on your wall. But we need to stop.
Stop!
Read before unpacking.
Read before unpacking.
So Hasbro warns us to stop and read the packaging, and we get this really awesome, straight up, giant booklet like we used to get back in the good old days of Kenner, right? Like this guy right here. On the construction of the Katana, all the parts that go with it, and how to put together in the proper order so you do not jack up your $500 Katana. And again, it's got everything in there you need to do. Follow it step by step, guys. Do not stray from the instructions of the Katana. Okay, before we get going on this lovely barge, we're gonna cruise around the back because there's a couple items that we need to bring some detail to show you that all the way back here in the corner, Jabba the Hutt, the man himself, is hiding in this beautiful cutout spot for him. And there he is. We'll get a closer look at him here in just a second. Back over the other side is what a lot of you guys have been waiting for. That's right. There is Yak Face. And let's go ahead and look at this dude right now. Get a closer look. And here is the Yak Face on the original Power of the Force card that came out in the mid-80s. He looks awesome. Again, it's a brand new figure. It's not the original Yak Face that they did back in the day. It's not a rehash of that one. This is a brand new sculpt. Looks awesome. And this is a very, very exclusive figure. Again, only 8,810 of these we think exist. Who knows? Maybe, you know, Kenner might have more of these. Kenner, Hasbro might have a few more of these. But it's awesome to have this. It's gonna sit in my collection for a long time. And if you guys don't know this, if you go on eBay right now, people are selling the hell out of this thing for a huge amount of money. So this may be one of the rarest figures that Hasbro has ever done for Star Wars.
All right, we're gonna get right to the goods here. We're not gonna go over every step of the instructions, but we do wanna encourage you all who have the barge to go through the instructions, make sure you're doing it right so you don't damage your prized possession here. We're gonna take the parts off in the order that the instructions tell us to do so, and then we're gonna get right to it and start showing you the goods. Okay, so here's the box of the accessories, which comes out right after you take off that middle styrofoam piece. This includes all of your accessories, as well as the soft goods sails and the stands, as well as the deck cannon, various other little bits. It's rumored that the Katana began its life as a pleasure yacht in the days before Tatooine's mining bus.
Left abandoned to rot under the twin suns, the craft eventually came into Jabba's possession. The 30-meter-long craft has a crew of 25 and can entertain up to around 500 humanoid bipeds. To offset the increased weight and maintain emergency speeds of up to 50 knots over the Dune Sea, an unshielded Sorosub M9600 power drive maintains propulsion, as well as gives power to the 6 ventral repulsor lifts. From within the Katana, Jabba entertains his throng from atop his dais, which he can enter from the portside accessway. To sate his hunger, along with that of his guests, the staff work tirelessly from within the barge's fully stocked kitchen. Just as it is ready to maintain the creature comforts, the Katana is also equally prepared to act as an assault craft. A section below deck has been specially fitted as a staging area and armory. The Katana's cockpit features twin control stations, as is standard on any pleasure craft, to allow for redundancies in case one pilot needs a break. To keep Jabba's pilots focused on the task at hand, a brig has been conveniently installed directly behind the cockpit. There, Jabba keeps his last insubordinate member of his crew on display for all to see. On the sands of Tatooine, there is no other craft more feared and respected than the Katana. It is as luxurious as it is powerful, but like its owner himself, the craft's overbearing hunger for power may one day be its undoing.
All right, so let's quickly go through basic features of the Katana. So at the top, you can see we have these couple cannons that are movable. You can place them over here as well, or back over here in 3 different spots. As we move down, we have some hatches here that open up to a couple stairwells that you can take your figures down to the depths where Jabba's hanging out with Slave Leia doing weirdness. And then back over here, this hatch slides open, and this pops open to another set of stairs as well. And we have our cannon here that moves back and forth all the way around if you wanted to, and up and down. Of course, we have a hinge back over here. And the coolness is on the front portion of this Katana set, which all these panels up here pop off. But first, of course, like in Return of the Jedi, all the windows open up, and this one over here pops open as well for your alien figure to come flying out, just like in Return of the Jedi. So let's open up these panels that we have here, shall we? Ooh, there's one, and two, three, and four. So it will come. Let it come. You got all your areas. The Katana right here, rightly so displayed. But in the front, you can hang out with the pilot and his co-pilot when they pilot the Katana into the Tatooine dunes, sandstorms, all that great stuff, and battle who knows who. Just such an awesome, cool playset, and you guys gotta get one. It's too late though. Too late. You can't get it now. Unless you live in Europe, it's gonna be on sale there soon. So let's get to the sails. There are two, and what you want to do is put the back one on first. That's the most important one to put on, because if you don't put the back one on first, it will not go on right. So just slip something like that. You have your couple pieces here on the sides that slip right on. The stabilizers for your sails. And then from there, you grab your front again, making sure that they point down just like this. And bring your next one down into a slot that is being covered. Just like that. And again, you get your supports. Ah, there it goes. Very simple and easy. Putting the cells together is a little rough, but once it's together, it's a beautiful piece. It's an awesome ship. It's a great, awesome piece to have from HasLab. Hasbro, we thank you. Here we have the Katana, all decked out, all the Jawas, henchmen, and foes here. Yes.
Hanging out, listening to the music, relaxing, about to enjoy an execution as they do.
That's right. Oh my god, this thing is insane. Incredible to see everything done.
Props to Hasbro. This is the absolute paragon of Star Wars toys.
It is.
I wanted to believe that it was the big Millennium Falcon. It was produced many years back, or many years, 10 years back. Or not.
It's been a while, actually. You know, it's been quite some time since the BFM, right?
BMF,
sorry. Big Millennium Falcon has been released. That was a huge thing. This is beyond that. This is ridiculous.
Oh, absolutely.
How incredible it is. Oh my god, the sails look so awesome from the bottom. It's like you're in the set of Return of the Jedi, dude. Holy crap.
It's so great.
So freaking awesome. Man, now down over here, we have a little thing for you guys, the skiff.
Jabba. free us or die.
So that's how we leave
them. Down over here is our makeshift Sarlacc.
I'm supposed to get a close one
on. Good enough. Sorry.
An upside down Dungeons and Dragons. Yeah.
Yeah. That's right.
Whatever.
Yeah.
We don't mind that.
Sorry, we have a limited budget, even though we got the damn Catania. That's
Catana.
Jesus Christ, someone say Catania. Catania. That's amazing. Such an amazing set. That is so cool. Look at that.
Now, why is Dexter Jetster
Dexter?
Inside the kitchen here?
Oh, this guy? Well, he probably originally, was in episode 2 doing his thing at his 50s diner, and then he made his way over to be the cook for Jabba the Hutt, right?
There's got to be other employment opportunities than just Jabba's bar.
That's true.
Dexter's diner.
That's true. And over here we have our cell. Another guard. This playset. It's a playset. It's a vehicle, just like the Falcon was back in 1979 with Kenner. Playset, vehicle, carrying case, whatever it is. It's just amazing. This is such a sweet, beautiful thing. And, everybody discussed about, oh my gosh, $500. Well, I think that Hasbro has basically knocked out of the park with this thing. And it's that's how much it's basically worth. I mean, I know you're paying for the packaging as well. Be realistic, rather. But
let's not forget the booklet. I can't remember
the booklet that came with
inside
it.
Inside the or on the workbench or bench.
Just so cool.
That thing is really cool. It's got some great photos, production photos from the Return of Jedi that I've never seen before.
Yep.
Drafts of the original design for this thing from the quarry that I've never seen before. It's really tasteful.
Too super. So we do know that Hasbro is coming out with a new skiff here pretty soon, which will be an upgrade from this one here.
Under $50,
and you can go onto the HasLab right page now. Is it HasLab or what is it called?
No, you can sell it right now, or you can buy it. Right
sell
now.
It?
You can sell it. You can buy it right now from or pre-order it rather from Amazon.
Amazon has it, but Hasbro has their own new page you can join it to.
Oh, Pulse.
Pulse, that's right. Hasbro Pulse. There you go. You can pre-order it there if you'd like to as well. So, whatever you guys like to do. But this is quite amazing, and I'm so happy and thrilled that I have it. And, Matt's got one too, so.
Correct. Don't have room for it yet.
Nope.
So I'm living vicariously. Count.
That's right. So, there you go, guys. There it is. We waited a long time. We finally got it. And it's an amazing playset to have, carrying case. Ship, whatever you guys want to call it, but
sushi bar.
Yeah, here it is, guys. Jabba's Palace.
This is it.
No,
this
Jabba's sale bar.
This is the high bar. This is the high mark for Hasbro Star Wars toy collecting. Maybe they'll do something better beyond this.
Oh,
but
they're gonna make a Death Star. They're gonna make a Death Star. Just watch.
Or a 1/18th scale Bespin.
Sure.
I think that's what they're gonna do.
Sure.
I got a feeling they're gonna do it.
There it is. All right, guys, there it is. The Catania.
The Catana!
The Catan.
It's not Tranya
no.
from Star Trek. It's Catana.
Yes, the Catana. That's right, guys. The Catana. Jabba Sailbar. Get one now!
Right, guys, it's the end of episode 103. Thanks so much for stopping by and checking out my videos. I really do appreciate it. Check out Matt and I down on links below for Instagram and Twitter. Facebook and
all the shit.
All that stuff, and subscribe to me, Counts Thinkers, if you've not done it yet. Thanks a lot for watching this video, guys. Please leave comments down below and tell us what you think about the Catana right here. It's a super awesome playset, mega carrying case. Not sure what it is, but it's an awesome, stellar playset vehicle that Hasbro HasLab has done.
Insane.
Yes,
insane.
That's right, guys. But anyway, guys, don't stop collecting and have a great day!